Hey there, dudes and dudettes, and welcome back to Subnautica with me, Richie. I've done some little bit of work now, and I've managed to get some decent living quarters now. Bed with a teddy bear, some posters around the wall, and some various items. That's pretty cool, is that? Anyhow, onto the well, I'm going to be pressing on anyway. I've re-equipped myself. I've got the rebreather now fitted, so I'm going to head over to the Mushroom Caves just now to see what I can salvage from there. Oh, and I've got a radio message as well.
This is Life Pod 7. Coordinates attached. Pod is structurally sound, but the fabricator's bust. Requesting assistance. 7 out.
Signal coordinates corrupted. Approximate transmission origin recorded to data bank.
Let's see now. I'm coming to southwest of the. That's not a million miles away from where I am, actually. Over that way, something like that. Anyway, like I said, I'm going to head to the Mushroom Caves now. We found a beacon manager? Yep, there we go. Now, I put the beacon 3 down for a reason, but I can't remember what, so I'll check it out. Might be a wreck or something like that there. Maybe that is a wreck, actually. What I was looking for, that I thought had something shiny inside it. And there does indeed appear to be a wreck here. Yep, I think we've been inside here, haven't we? Inside. One of those, it might have been, had something blocking my way in, like a door that needs to be lasered open, I mean. Yep. So let's see what what's behind door number one. I also should have recharged my laser cutter, actually. But I can swap around batteries, that's not a problem. Yeah, logic of putting a laser cutter in a room where you need to laser to get into. I think I've got everything else that I need, actually. In here for me. So what I'll do is I'll grab that beacon and put it somewhere else. I can't remember where I put it. Where did I put it? Oh, there we go. If I get some diamonds, I can make a modification station. Then I can upgrade my depth module for my Seamoth for that. Which will let me go up to maybe 500, is it? 600? Something in that region. I think that coupled with the rebreather will let me progress just a little bit further. Yep, got a wreck here. I need to just quickly check over. No, guess I've already been in that one. So, go as deep as I can. Not too bad at a minute. Let's start grabbing minerals now. Diamond, beautiful.
Certain conditions in this gate support a microcosm of the unique, possibly predatory life forms. Detecting an artificial structure somewhere in the region.
And that we'll definitely check out. We just need lithium. I need some magnetite as well for something. I think that might be for the Seamoth upgrade. I'll try and avoid these snake creatures. Floating rocks. Yep, what have we got now? I thought that was something then. Gotta be something in here somewhere. There's something I can definitely see there. Maybe this way. Maybe not. In the meantime, I should also grab quite a lot of the materials here, because there's some quite difficult, tricky to get stuff, or tricky for me anyway. I'm in a fairly early stage at the minute. Well, that'll help with the laser cutter if I need it. Okay, oh, there's something here. Yep, I do believe we have a base here. Look around the outside. Oh, yeah, shiny. Oh, wicked.
New blueprint acquired.
We're really pimping my base at this rate. So all helps, it's all good for progression.
New blueprint acquired.
And if I can get another Yeah, I really don't like it when they do that. I'm sure there should be another part for the nuclear reactor knocking around here. Another part I can scan. Somewhere. Where is it? Maybe not. Do a quick circle round it. Some more good materials there. Probably just missed it or something. I think the best thing to do is to get in there and start scanning like crazy. I'm sure there's a lot in there I can use. And first of all, saw PDA.
Integrating new PDA data.
Sure, I can't dismantle this base actually. I could make a good use of all the resources in here.
Integrating new PDA data.
I've got that and I'll be putting it to damn good use. It's time to put some of those logs on and let you have a listen to them. Okay, so I can go back to the Aurora and get those.
For me it was childish, but I stare out of the window and sometimes I think how lucky I am to see this world up close. Back on the island, I wouldn't have believed the creatures that live down here. The fish, they glow. There's one that's 90% eyeball. Snakes twice the length of a habitat compartment. Certainly, it's not all friendly. Most of the plant life is toxic. Learned that the hard way. But I've managed to coax some marble melons into growing indoors. And when they don't cover our dietary needs, well, we eat the fish themselves. It's a bit gross, but there's nothing they wouldn't do. I've been attempting to document my findings. Father approves. He says, understanding is power. That the more we know about this planet, the more we can use it to our advantage. I'm just doing it because it's fun. It's not easy without proper equipment and network access. But the old-fashioned way, observing, taking notes, testing theories, shows me the world in a way a spectroscopic analysis never could. Lately, I've been watching the crab snakes. They ambush their prey as it tries to feed on the mushrooms they hide in. What they don't eat settles on the seabed, which fertilizes the mushrooms, which feeds the herbivores, and so the chain continues. Co-evolution gives me the fuzzies.
head back to the Aurora. I've got space for a couple more bits. I'll pick up some treasure and get these playing off and head back home.
Something incredible just happened. Since we're down here, I had this plan to build equipment and study the life forms we were encountering, but I didn't have enough enameled glass. So, I started looking for a natural substrate that would strengthen the glass we have, and those stalker teeth we've been finding fit the bill. Only, well, we needed more. That's when Marguerite got interested. She actually listened to me. More than I can say for Father. And I worked up the courage to talk about my more tentative theories. When I told her they were attracted to metal deposits, that their teeth get dislodged when they pick them up, her eyes narrowed and she dashed out of the room. 3 hours later, she came back, her pack loaded down with stalker teeth. I asked her about it. She shrugged and said my theories were good. Said she had the meeting out of the palm of her hand. I think she meant it literally. She is incredible. She went out to the kelp forest armed with just a heat blade and went fin to fin with a pack of stalkers. On the one hand, that is the coolest thing I have ever heard. On the other, well, I hope the stalkers didn't come off worse than Marguerite did. She had a huge gash on her forearm. I don't think things went as smoothly as she made out. And what's the point in surviving here if we have to kill everything that makes it so wonderful? I wish I knew more about these animals. But Father won't let me leave the habitat. Maybe with all this glass, we could build a containment unit and get up close to them.
Okay, I'll get the power cell charged. Bugger. Are you fucking kidding me? Did he just vanish into thin air? Fuck. Still got plenty of power, so that's not an issue. Get my habitat builder out and start not getting shit on. I think I'll have a wall locker for the diamond and one for the magnetite. Lithium as well. I'm going to be collecting it in large quantities. Right, let's make sure I get all the lithium out of here and diamond. So the modification station, what does that need? I think I've got everything actually for that. The computer chip, and for that I need 2 table coral samples. So 1 and 2. And copper wire. There's only 2 copper. gold as well, we've got that. I need some more lead for the station. I'm just thinking here. One diamond as well. So yep, that's everything. What's your high capacity for lithium I need? How much have I got? Hey, beautiful. What other things are there I can build? Need more rubies, I know where to get those. Any more glass? Plastic ingot. I think I need, might need a stalker tooth for that. Did I not pick one of those up? I'm sure I got one somewhere in my travels. Oh, maybe not. Let's check quickly. No, maybe not. What else can I build that could be useful? That could come in handy if I don't have everything I need for that. What fins? I think the main thing to do is to build the Seamoth depth modules. So, let's see what I need. Take that out. Let's even get some stalker teeth quickly. Maybe I can just throw some scrap metal in front of one of them. Right, let's get the rest of the logs playing. Now, I've played those two already, but not this one.
I said wait for the storm to pass. Your life's more valuable to me than a plant patch.
You stopped being in charge when the ship you were captaining sunk.
I'll stop being in charge when you take charge of yourself.
Say, Chief. Chief.
What?
Do you know how to drain those grow beds of 40 tons of storm water? Or how to conjure food from the air?
I know how to prioritize.
I'm just saying, if that's so, what's your boy's life worth? Day. If tomorrow you're gonna be so hungry you start wondering what it tastes like, let him go deal with the plants.
Son, go deal with the plants.
Bard, Torgo, has disembarked the habitat.
Interfere with my family again, and when rescue arrives, I will leave you here. Do you understand me?
No rescue coming, Chief. Not in time. No staying here neither. This rain keeps falling, sooner or later this place will be buried. Only choice we got is whether to get buried with it.
So, I've got a stalker tooth now, so I've got plenty of quartz, so I can make some enamel glass. I think it's titanium I need for the titanium I need for the iron and lithium for the ingot. So let's first things first, quartz. Couple of quartz. Might as well refine that while I'm at it. Charging nicely. Let's see what do I need. Seamoth upgrade. plus steel ingots. Just think it from my memory resource correctly. Titanium and the lithium. I'll need two. So I probably need to nip back to that cave and get some more lithium from there. But I can also actually build the moon pool now, so get that set up and running, and then I don't have to hassle around with the swapping around power cells. Right, what else do I need? Two magnetite. And I think depth is probably 500, something like that. Requirements I need to actually build a moon pool. Exterior pieces, base pieces. I can build a thermal plant, but I've got no way of actually getting the power. I need the power transferers, titanium ingots, lubricant, and lead. How much lead do I have? Yeah, I've got enough. Titanium, do I have enough? Nope. The next thing to do is get some food ready. Actually, I'm alright for food, it's just water I need. Oh yeah, and I can build a filtration machine, can't I? So it's all coming together now, just steadily. Couple wire aerogel. Titanium. What do I need for aerogel again? Advanced aerogel. Bugger, I need some rubies. I need quite a few rubies. I think what I should do is should do a mission to get some ruby, some to get some more lithium, some to get some more titanium. Not titanium. To head over to try and find where I've got those. Actually, first of all, need to plant some more of these blood seeds. Now we've got a plentiful supply when I get back. Yeah, just need some. Need to get the rubies now. I need to get a ton of rubies, really. A ton of rubies, and maybe we can get some of those other mushrooms as well. While I'm at it, that'll give me a good, nice boost. I need to do nice find a way into the abyss. On the plus side, I can go down to 500 depth now, so got some good decent chance of finding it. And I'll need to pick up a ton of titanium along the way as well. Is this it round here? No, of course not. What formation is that? Bulb zone, that's not quite what I'm looking for. But maybe there's something down here worth getting. Start checking the walls now for rubies. No. Yep, and I just heard one of the warpers. I feel there's another base around here somewhere as well. Remember where exactly. That's Uranite, is it? It's useful, but not useful to me at the minute. Holy shit. Well, only one thing for him, so we can get, from here. Fuck. Oh, those are real motherfuckers. And I think I'm boned. Oh, those sons of a bitches. Great, well, suppose I'll build another Seamoth, I guess. I'll be back once I've got that up and running, and I've got a moon pool for it to go with, and a depth charge module. This may take some time.